Hey, what's going on, everybody? Gordon Mattart here, and I just want to welcome you to another episode of Gordon's Training. What is going on, world? Hope that so far you had a great beginning of the week. It's been a while since I've jumped on live because of many things that's happening right now. So grateful to be back, grateful to be here with you. And in this episode, in this live training, I'm going to talk about limiting beliefs. Okay, this is an interesting subject that I really wanted to cover for a very long time, and it's great to share this sometime with you and give you value, because this is what it's all about. It's all about giving value to others all around the world. In fact, let me know in the comments below where you are tuning in. So, and also if you're watching this live, that's great. If you're watching this replay, hashtag replay, or maybe R, type in R in the comments below. So let's see if everything is okay before I get into the information. Just hold 1 second and let's check this. Awesome. Okay. All right. Video's okay.
Welcome.
Yes. Awesome. Okay. So we're live. Good. Audio's good. Video's good. Okay. So limiting beliefs. A lot of people suffer from these limiting beliefs, and in fact I can share with you start sharing with you my story on limiting beliefs that I had many, especially, and every time my goal is to chase my limiting beliefs in order to destroy and crush before they crush me. You see, a lot of people have a lot of limiting beliefs. In fact, if you are one of them, if you have ever had limiting beliefs, let me know in the comments below if you are one of them. We have a limiting belief that you cannot do something because of. Okay, you cannot do something because of. And this is what most people holds them back, is that something. Okay, it could be fear, it could be they don't believe in themselves, it could be something that is holding them back in order to grow more, in order to achieve more, in order to raise the bar on whatever they are doing when it comes to business, especially, and when it comes to everything, sport, everything, life as well. So what are your limiting beliefs? Are you working on your limiting beliefs? So number one fear in the world, you know what it is? It's not debt. Most people think it's debt. People fear about debt, okay? So you cannot negotiate that, okay? When the one above you calls you, you gotta do what you gotta do, right? So number one, fear, human fear, is public speaking. So this was one of mine, okay? This was one of my limiting beliefs. I couldn't see myself talking, let alone on live, Facebook live like this, or perhaps in front of people, okay? Nowadays, also like Zoom, in front of people, also live in front of people. Why? Because it was my limiting belief. Nobody told me that I could do it. Nobody showed me how to do it. But I had to work on that. So question to you is this: are you working on your limiting beliefs? Are you working on crushing that limiting belief before it crushes you? And I see, and I connect with a lot of people from different walks of life, from different parts of the world. And what I see is one thing, that most people who succeed, they work on their limiting beliefs. They want to crush it. They are willing to get uncomfortable to crush that limiting beliefs, because all it is a thought. A lot of people buy their own thoughts instead of buying, okay, or renting out someone's successful thought and apply it in their life. Okay, I was talking with a friend of mine, okay, and he wanted to write a book, and he had everything. He had the resources, he had the videos, he had the images, and he started to work on it. But when he saw somebody else maybe doing it a little bit different, maybe he had more knowledge than him, maybe he had more, let's say, better images and stuff like that, he stopped, because he said, oh, okay, he put that limiting belief, oh, this guy has better images, this guy has better content maybe, or this guy has better knowledge. So he stopped because of thinking that he couldn't be the person who creates something that other people found value, they can purchase it, they can learn from it, and they can apply it. And this is what holds most people back. It's just comparitis, okay? The disease called comparitis. You compare your results right now with somebody else. In fact, this is something that also a lot of people, I see a lot of people in my profession that they do. And unfortunately, this is why they give up. They give up because they measure, okay? They measure their success with just the income-wise, with just the where they are right now in their ranks, instead of really go deep on why that person it is where he is where he is or she is where he is, where they are, okay? Because of many things that you don't know. So don't just never compare yourself. Number one thing, never compare yourself with somebody else when it comes to results, the journey. You've got to focus on your journey. A lot of people miss that, okay? Yes, there are going to be struggles. Yes, there's going to be things that you need to learn. There's going to be skills, which is another limiting belief. A lot of people, they are not willing to step up is because they don't focus on increasing their skill. When you increase your skill, the fear goes down, okay? Thumbs up if you agree with this. If you improve your skills, okay? In our profession, there are 5-7 skills that you need to master. So once you start mastering them, and how, it's not just reading about them, it's doing the work and you apply them, okay? People tend to look for the right script to do things rather than just try, okay? Rather than just do actually, not try. So that's a limiting belief. It creates a limiting belief. And when that happened, my suggestion is go back to the basics. Always go back to the basics. So the basics are the thing that you need to master. And as I said, as I was saying, that a lot of people create that limiting belief that they can do it. They cannot do it, sorry. They cannot do it. They cannot do something. And this is why they will be called groupie nowadays, is a new word, okay? Which means they go and learn. They continue to go and learn, which is good, okay? Attending events, always I encourage that. Very, very powerful. But then, when they got back, when nobody is watching them, they just go back to the old habits. Why? Because they still have that limiting belief, that thought, okay, that somebody else is maybe better than them, rather than focusing on applying what they have learned and just keep moving forward. So it is, everyone has limiting beliefs, but question is, are they crushing you? Are they crushing you or are you crushing them? What are you doing right now? What are you doing right now to crush those limiting beliefs? Are you working harder on yourself or are you just focusing on distractions? I was talking with my team a couple of days ago, okay, in Europe, and basically it's two things that one pushes themselves in a direction that they either want or they are right now because they don't know what they don't know. It's two things, priorities and distractions. Guess what? There's a lot of distractions around the world. Do you agree? Okay, let me know if you agree. If there is a lot of distractions. Let me tell you, when internet, social media comes in, there's a lot of distractions. And I am one of those, okay? I am guilty, one of those, that some of the time I'm caught in the distractions, okay? But here's the thing, it's all about choices. Choices will define you wherever you want to go. It's either the distraction way or the priorities way. You've got to prioritize the things that you care most about. If it's just your business, you've got to eliminate distractions, okay? I'm not afraid nowadays to say no to a lot of things. Why? Because I know my purpose. I know where I'm heading. Okay. I know where I'm going. Do you know where you're going? Ask yourself that question. Answer that question. Do you know where you're going? If you don't have something that you have designed that you want to go after, somebody else will hire you to do that for them. So again, never allow your limiting beliefs, my friends, because a limiting belief will turn into a distraction. You will be immersed into distractions. And that those distractions will like keep you away from whatever you want to do, from whatever you want to achieve. So focus on simple, keep simple things, but effective. Make sure they are effective. Okay. What is that you're doing? Is it effective for your business that you're growing? Are they effective? The move that you're going to do, is it strategic enough to get you where you want to go, or maybe get you to a different level than you are right now? So again, limiting beliefs, my friend, are they crushing you or you're crushing them? I hope that you find value out of this. For more free trainings like this, hop on gordonattar.com, www.gordonattard.com. Okay, go get the free gift that I'm giving out as well in that. There's five things that I'm giving out there, because I want to just giving you value as well from the things that I have learned and I'm applying as well in the journey of my business. Once again, never compare yourself with somebody else's journey. It is your journey. Make sure you just embrace it, hold on, and just keep your head up and keep moving forward. So again, hope that you found value. Share this around. If you did, tag your people that maybe they have limiting beliefs. Who do you know they have limiting beliefs that maybe this can give them some thoughts, give them some things, like some tips and that they can apply basically in their business or maybe in their life. Because if you crush this, okay, if you just remove your limiting beliefs, which are limiting thoughts as well, you will see yourself going to a different direction, okay, going to a different level. That's all I have for you. Hope that you, again, enjoy this. This was episode 53 from all these episodes, the Gordon's Training. You'll find this also if you're watching this. You can watch the other episodes on YouTube, on my YouTube channel. Just type in Gordon Attard and make sure you subscribe and comment or like in there as well. So that's all. I'm going to wrap this up. Have a great rest of the week, my friends, and I'll see you soon on yet another episode. God bless. Bye-bye.